I am Brother Matthew. Thank you for tuning in once again.
He will lift up Jesus ever.
Delivered by our General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi.
Now, as you look at Daniel chapter 3, we find the hour of suffering and the hour of persecution and the hour of the tyrant wanting to oppress, wanting to destroy the people of God. But in that hour of suffering, the power of the supernatural came to be manifested on behalf of the people of God. And because there is a God who changes not, and because we have the Christ who is the same yesterday and today and forever, that's the reason we know when our hour comes, there is power for our hour. In a good amen. Daniel chapter 3 verse 15. Now, if you be ready, that at what time you hear the sound of the cornet, the flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, and dulcimer, and all kinds of music, you fall down and worship the image that I have made. Well, but if you worship not, you shall be cast the same hour, that's the hour of threatening, the hour of the tyrant, and the hour of this domineering personality, intimidating, frightening, terrifying the people of God, and saying, when the time comes, and you see the signal, if you fall down and fall in line, and do what I, the king of Babylon, what I, the tyrant of the land, what I, the destroyer of human progress and human life, what I decree, if you fall down, forget about God, and forget about conviction, and forget about your hope in the Lord, listen to me. I'm the one in charge. You fall down and worship what I tell you to worship, that will be all right. But if you refuse, that same hour you'll be cast in the midst of a burning, fiery furnace. And who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hands? What an hour! It's an hour challenge. What an hour. It's an hour when the test comes upon your life, whether you have the power for the hour or not. Thank God for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And I thank God for you. I said, I thank God for you. You will not bow. You will not bend. You will not give up your face at the time when it matters to stand. I was told in verse 16, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, the living straight in the face eyeball to eyeball. And he said, O Nebuchadnezzar, the evil called him by his name directly, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. If it be so, those people have the power for the hour. And I want to tell you, you have the power for the hour. And it doesn't matter. What Nebuchadnezzar is threatening, it doesn't matter. What the people who see that your life is in their hand, it doesn't matter. What the people who see that your destiny and the direction of your life, your decisions, whether you are happy or you are not happy, and whether you succeed or you don't succeed, the same. It's not the brain you have, it's not the plan you have, it's in our hands. That's what Nebuchadnezzar was saying. He says, I don't care for your conviction, I don't care for the doctrine you believe, I don't care for the faith you think you have. Your destiny is in my hands. And he said, Nebuchadnezzar, you'll see, the person that has the power is not the one that brags, and it's not the one that says, this is what I will do. They said, if it be so, our God, who we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will. Think about that. He said, here is the proposal, and here is the confidence we have in the Lord. He is able. Your God is able. The one who opened the Red Sea is still there. He is able. And the one that made the Jericho walls so far down, he is still there the same, never changing. He is able. And the one that destroyed 185,000 of the army of Sennacherib at the time of the people of God is there. He is able. And the one that opened blind eyes, and the one that made Jesus our Lord and Savior to rise from the dead, and the one that manifested power, unlimited power, immeasurable power, even to raise Jesus from the dead after rolling away the stone, he's still there. Our God is able to deliver us from the very, very furnace, and he will deliver us out of thine hand, O King. Let's see now the power for that hour. We're looking at verse 27. And the princes and the governors and the captains and the kings, counselors, being gathered together, saw these men. That's after they cast them into the fire. They called them out. They went in just to fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ. And then after some time, they came out of the fire. This day you are coming out of the fire. Burning in your brain, and burning in your body, and burning in your family, and burning all around you. See the flames of Nebuchadnezzar going up. You're coming up because there is power for your hour. And then it says, the soul of these men, upon whose bodies the fire had no power. The fire had no power. The fury had no power. The machinations and maneuvering of the enemy will not have any power upon your life. Nor was an hair of their head singed. Neither was their clothes changed. Nor the smell of fire passed on them. That's the power for the hour. We're talking about the power to turn bondage to breakthrough. I thought you'll say amen. Yesterday's bondage will turn to today's breakthrough. The power, the supernatural power that turns bondage into breakthrough, and it will happen today. To you, for you, it will happen in Jesus' name. After this transformation of your bondage to your breakthrough, the waters of suffering in the past that have been raging and roaring, all that will come to a calm in Jesus' name. I'm looking at Psalm 116. Psalm 116. From verse 16. O Lord, truly, I am thy servant. I am thy servant. He repeats that again. And the son of the handmaid, thou hast used my bonds. Your life, anything that enemy tied up, there is a using taking place in Jesus' name. I will offer to you the sacrifice of thanksgiving. And I will call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows unto the Lord now in the presence of all his people. Then it says in verse 19, in the courts of the Lord's house, in the midst of me, O Jerusalem, praise ye the Lord. He'll lose your body. He'll take the body away. He will destroy the works of the devil in your life in Jesus' name. Jeremiah chapter 30, I'm reading from verse 8. Jeremiah chapter 30. We're looking at verse 8. For it shall come to pass in that day, says the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from off thy neck. The yoke is broken. The body is removed. The bondage is turned unto breakthrough. And I will burst thy bonds. And strangers shall no more serve themselves of him. People you don't know tormenting your life, those days are gone. The people you don't know, you went to school, you didn't know them. You got your job, you didn't know them. When you were sweating to be able to get qualified, they were nowhere to be found. Now you sweated and you got the job. Now you sweated and you got the wife. Now you sweated and got the husband. Now you sweated and built a house. Now you sweated. And after sweating and sweating and sweating, burning the midnight candle, now you got the reward, the promise of what God said, I will give to the faithful. And then a stranger that didn't know, when you are struggling and sweating and reading and studying and praying and fasting and waiting upon the Lord, the stranger showed up and he said, hey, wait on, come on here. Success does not depend on praying, fasting, struggling, studying, and doing whatever. Success depends on me, the stranger. If I say you will not succeed, you will not succeed. If I say you will not be happy, you will not be happy. God forbid. I said, God forbid. You will trample on all those strangers in Jesus' name. Think about a man that on his life, all that he got, he put it into what he wants to do in life. And then somebody, after you have labored for so long, for many years, somebody one night appears in the dream, and you don't even know this fellow. This is a stranger. And he says, I'm telling you that, you know, we are here, and since we are here, you'll never make it. And I say, get out of that place. I said, get out of that place. They meet you in the dream, we conquer them. My prayers for you will conquer them. The promise of Jesus will conquer them. The power of the Holy Ghost in this day of his power will conquer them in Jesus' name. And I want to tell you, don't live your life on dreams. Don't you live your life on the sweat of a stranger, somebody you don't know. Don't you know Jesus? Don't you know God? Don't you know the Holy Ghost? Don't you know the promise of your Father? And then a stranger comes and he says, your destiny depends on me. I command those strangers to vanish away right now in Jesus' name. Look at that verse 8 again. It tells us in verse 8, but shall come to pass. In that day, says the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from off thy neck, and will burst thy bounds, and strangers shall no more serve themselves of him, but they shall serve the Lord their God, and David their king, whom I will raise up unto them. Therefore, fear thou not, O my servant Jacob, says the Lord, neither be dismayed, O Israel, for lo, I will save thee from afar, and thy seed from the land of the captivity. And Jacob shall return, and shall be rest and be quiet, and none shall make him afraid. In a good amen there. In verse 17, for I will restore. Everybody say restoration. Your day of restoration has come in Jesus' name. For I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, says the Lord, because they called thee an outcast, saying, this is Zion whom no man seeketh after. For things are changing. I said things are changing. And they are changed forever, completely, permanently in Jesus' name. The power to turn bondage to breakthrough. 3 points like Jacob's on here before we break all those yokes. Before we destroy all those things, the works of the devil away from your life. From today, you'll never be the same again. Point number one, different forms of bondage. Different forms of bondage. Point number two, definite freedom from bondage. Definite freedom from bondage. Number three, dynamic faith for breakthrough. Dynamic faith for breakthrough. Number one, different forms of bondage. You need to know the problem before you see the solution. You need to understand the bondage before you enjoy, experience the breakthrough. Different forms of bondage. Psalm 107 verse 10. Psalm 107 verse 10. Such as sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, being bound in affliction and iron. That's a kind of bondage. They try to move forward. There's a chain of iron on their legs. They try to make progress. There is a kind of bondage of iron that is tying them down, holding them back. And they try to have the good things of life. And they say, so and so got it.